This week on Maker Update, movie magic with motors, mini motorways with magnets, a 3D printed typewriter, and professional looking panels on the cheap. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we find all the cool stuff that makers are making and share them with you so you can get inspired or learn new tools and techniques to help you with your own projects. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. This is a really stacked show, so let's get going with the project of the week. Creating special effects for productions like Star Wars might seem well out of reach for the most of us. But it turns out that that galaxy is a whole lot closer than you might think. In a recent video on Tested, Adam Savage met with John Knoll to get a tour of his home-built motion control system that has executed shots for both The Mandalorian and Skeleton Crew. Just to be clear, we're talking about this John Knoll. And this John Knoll. He's been building motion control and visual effects systems for Industrial Light and Magic and Adobe for a very long time. But excusing that, the heart of this story is that the evolution of Arduino and hobbyist electronics has really democratized how systems like this can be built in your own small shop. Powering this entire system is a teensy microcontroller. Most of the linear axes are made from aluminum extrusion. Even this control board looks like a really custom job. The other big surprise here is that you would think that shots like these are captured on a high-end cinema camera, but instead, he's using a fairly pedestrian Canon 5D. These shots aren't captured in real time, but instead are a long series of still photos. This gives the visual effects compositors more image resolution to work with. And everything is filmed in multiple passes, so they can tune the image exactly how they want. He's also using vintage lenses because they offer him more control over the captured image. In fact, some of the lenses used for shots in The Mandalorian were captured using the very same lenses used on The Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi. Maybe it sounds strange to be talking about camera systems from ILM on this show, but this is really a testament to how accessible this technology has become. And while it's certainly not easy to build motion control systems like this one, it's certainly within our reach. Motion control and visual effects have been a lifelong fascination for me personally, and it's wonderful to get this intimate look at how it all comes together. More projects. I was really struck by this 3D printed recreation of the starting map of the game Mini Motorways. This is a game about managing the roadway systems of a growing city, and its graphic design is really stunning. So stunning, in fact, that Matthew Lin was compelled to create his own 3D printed automata of it in action. The delight here is that all of the motion is created by a single microservo. Its rotation drives these two gears, each of which have these slots in them that guide the magnetic cars along their roadway paths. It would be enough to marvel at the creative and physical design of this project, but there's a tiny little twist to it. The brains here are an ESP32C3 that ties into the TomTom GPS API, and that checks what the local traffic conditions are like. When it's busy, the model slows down, and when the traffic is light, it moves more quickly. It's a gorgeous project. Laura Kampf has a video out on her everyday carry kit, or as she calls it, her emotional support tool roll. She built this in partnership with Mafia Bags in San Francisco. And there's a ton of really clever considerations here. First among which is this main clasp, called a fidlock buckle. It magnetically snaps in place, but can only be released by sliding it vertically. There's plenty of pockets for your tools, as well as bigger pockets to secure your odds and ends, documents, and more. There's also this detachable ratchet strap belt that also just works as a ratchet strap when you need one. This is a great piece of kit with a lot of clever considerations. You also need to appreciate this 3D printed typewriter created by Toast. We've all been there. You're grazing YouTube and you fall down a rabbit hole of a particular tool, and that's where this project came from. Over the course of this video, you get to learn how we overcame the challenges of rigidity of 3D printed parts, how to keep the keystrokes from smearing, and how a mobile game inspired the advancing mechanism. It's a wonderful journey and well worth your time. And finally, we have a treasure hunt game powered by BLE beacons, created by Playful Technology. I've always been fascinated by the idea of locative experiences, and my thought has always been around QR codes, but his implementation using BLE beacons is so much better, because he's able to enforce that his players need to stand in the exact right spot to unlock the next element. The player has this book with an e-ink display revealing the next clue, and it's updated with every new gameplay reveal. This is all powered by these store-bought BLE beacons that are small, waterproof, and can run for a few years on just a coin cell battery. Not only is this a fantastic idea, but he provides an outstanding playbook for how you can implement this in your own experiences. Time for some tips and tools. Here to Record has a great video on why this ultra-wide screen display for a Raspberry Pi has become one of his favorite production tools and how he uses it. This is a 320 by 1480 capacitive touch display that mounts directly to a Pi. In his case, he uses it as a production clock, but can also split the display to show important websites or other info related to the production that he's working on. Distracted by Design has a video about the struggle of keeping focus on your projects. He breaks his own projects into three different categories. A Type 1 project can be completed in around an hour. Type 2 is a little bit more elaborate, but what he considers a Type 3 project is where you can easily get lost in the weeds and even abandon a project in frustration. But this is a great exploration on how to stay focused and continue to improve a project as you're working on it. Speaking of making well-finished projects, Accidental Science has this wonderful video on how to make professional-looking panels for your own projects. He begins with his design in Inkscape, and he offers lots of great design tips, like separating your markings from your general layout as separate layers. From there, you just get your design professionally printed and laminated, and then apply it to your panel with glue, and then make the necessary cutouts. It's an elegant solution with a great look. And from Adafruit, we have a cool new board that lets you easily control up to 8 solenoids via I2C. If you've ever worked with solenoids, you know they need to be triggered by high voltage, which is fine if you're only using one or two of them. But if you're, I don't know, making a project where you need them to strike the keys of a xylophone, you need a lot more of them, and that project scales up really fast. This board makes projects like that easy to build, and thanks to Adafruit's documentation, you'll be well supported along the way. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we're looking at an older video about how to select a proper wireless technology for your project. We've covered a few wireless projects in this episode, and it's always key to know the pros and cons of each one to make sure your implementation is the best. Whether you want to use Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, LoRa, or cellular, this video covers the essentials and the security concerns of each one. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, that you can get more info about every single one of these projects by checking out the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.